Hey guys, welcome to the Prepping Preacher. This is Brother Tim, man. I am so glad that you're here. I hope God has truly blessed you, man. It's been such a beautiful day, and I wanted to welcome you to my back porch here. Just going to sit out and talk to you for a minute about a subject that's dear to my heart. That's being a Christian and also being a prepper. Some people don't believe that those two go hand in hand, and I believe that they're so intertwined that you cannot separate them. So stay tuned. We're going to take a look. Hey guys, welcome to the Prepping Preacher. This is Brother Tim, and I'm so glad that you're here, and I hope God's truly blessing you. I hope you're having a beautiful day, and welcome to my back patio here. Just as you can hear the birds right now just chirping in the background, but I want to talk about a subject, but before I do, I want to thank you, all the ones that have showed your support and subscribed and the comments and the likes, all that. I appreciate it. And if it's your first time, man, hit that subscribe button, ring that bell. I always joke and say, we'll treat you so many ways, one of them got to be right. But we're getting our voice out, and I want to thank you. And that voice is pro-God. That voice is pro-family. That voice is pro-life. That voice is pro-gun, Second Amendment, and pro these United States. And again, a shout-out to my brothers and sisters in arms. God bless you, and I hope that he watches over you. But we are getting our voice out. And a matter of fact, and we're getting comments, all different kinds of comments, and I appreciate them. I have fun with some of them. There's a lot of skippies out there, if you know what I mean. But there's no reason to be rude, though. And if you're rude to some of the congregation, rude to some of the people in this chat, well, trust me, I will eliminate you off this list, because you don't need to be here if you're going to be rude. But I want to talk about something that some people say doesn't line up, and that's being a Christian and being a prepper. And I have to disagree with them, because I don't believe they've really gotten into God's word like they should. And some will say, well, you're not showing any faith in God. No, brother, I'm showing all faith in God. My God is sovereign. My God's in control. And I know that. And all things work for a reason, just as they did with Joseph. But if you don't know that story, well, get in your Bible and find it. But it's sad today, because so many people think that they're supposed to sit there and wait for a handout. And that's what bugs me to death. We're called to take care of our own. I mean, as a matter of fact, Paul told us in 1 Timothy 5, he said that one does not provide for his own, especially for his own household or his own family, has denied the faith and is worse than an infidel. Now, if you've watched any of my videos, you've heard me say that. There's no other place worse than being somebody who's denied the faith and is an infidel, an unbeliever. That's what he's talking about there. And so we're called to take care of our family. And then I can take it even further. I mean, Proverbs 6 says, consider the ant, you sluggard, who gathers during the summer, the harvest, so that they'll have it during the winter. Well, that's what we're called to do. And that's what prepping, putting food back and putting meds back and putting water back and putting protection back, whatever it may be, prepping for hard times. And I'm not talking about a zombie apocalypse. I'm not talking about, you know, just a total Armageddon. I know that one day he's coming back, and what a day that'll be when I meet my Savior face to face. But until then, I'm supposed to do everything I can to take care of my family. And people say, well, you know, how much is your family? What is considered your family, you know? Let me put it this way. James 1 tells us that pure and undefiled religion before God and the Father is this, to visit orphans and widows in their trouble, and to keep oneself unspotted from the world. There's pure religion, or there's pure worship of God when we do that. And so when I say family, I'm talking about those that can't take care of themselves also, that's around me, that's in my circle or in my world. And there are some widows, there are some different people that I will be able to help if things go bad. There have been times that I've been able to use my preps to help families out. And that's what we're called to do, is to help others. But I fall back again, though, to God's word, which is the only absolute I got, is, Paul speaking to the church of Thessalonica in Thessalonica 3. anyone who will not work, neither shall they eat. Well, and I want to explain something. Okay, if the balloon goes up, it gets bad, and you hear people talk, well, there may be, how could you turn somebody away? Well, we have enough little extra that we can hand out, especially a family. And I'm talking families here with little children, man, because it's heartbreaking. I see it today, and we're not even with the balloon situation up. But we can help those children out. But as far as grown folk that aren't going to turn a hand to take care of their family, much less take care of themselves, they're usually standing there with their hand out. Folks, I'm here to give a hand up, not a hand out. And if things get bad, you know, we can hand a little bit of it out to people we don't know, and especially ones that are able to do. I have a major problem with people that they're seeing what's going on in this world right now, and it's not getting any better. And they're not taking steps. They just don't have, common sense is no longer common. And so, you know, for them, I really have no mercy for them, to be honest with you. I can give them a little bit and send them on their way, so to speak, but I'm not going to feed them without them doing anything. Now, that's something you can think about, too, is that if the balloon's gone up, well, there's going to be work to be done. I'm talking hard work. And there may be some fields to be plowed. There may be some wood to be chopped. There may be some water to be hauled. And folks, the ones that didn't take care of themselves, well, guess what? They're going to have to trade out that labor for the ones that were wise, the ones that put up, like the ants. And some people go, well, that's just unchristian. I said, well, I don't know where you're getting your definition of Christian at. Again, I fall back, anyone who will not work shall not, neither shall they eat. God's word, not mine. We are the first line of charity. The church is. That's what we were called to be, not the government. And but that charity is for those that actually need it. Man, you know, I'm a firm believer. If you can work, well, you get off your dead self and get up and work. And here's the thing. And if you're working, put some stuff back. That's what it's about. But yes, a Christian should be a prepper. You should be putting stuff back. You know, now people say, well, what if the marauders come? You know, I had somebody wanting to go, said, well, what if they come and take it from you? Well, good luck, because I'm a sheepdog. Number one, I'm called to stand in that gap. My God has put me in that position, and I'm here to take care of mine. I'm here to take care of the the ones around me, the ones that can't take care of themselves, and I'm going to do everything I can, and funny thing is, as a preacher, I can take care of business both ways. I can say some words over the ground if it has to go to that. But I'm going to die trying to protect those that are around me, just because that's what that. Well, I know it's missed today, but that's what a man's supposed to do today. So, I hope this gives you a little insight. You know, of being a Christian and being a prepper. We're not some nut running around in our camouflage out in the woods. And if you're doing that, I don't mean to dish you there, but we're here to take care of our families and to help each other out. I love the community of the preppers. Guys, they're tight, and that's the way it should be. And so it's a family, and we will take care of each other. And we'll talk more about that, of getting groups together and getting people together of like minds. But yes, a Christian and a prepper, they should be one and the same. You should be preparing. Now, the best preparation anybody could make, the first preparation that everybody should make, is accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I mean, that's preparing for that future, the total future, because, man, I got a mansion. He's working on me a mansion right now. You know, yeah, I'm not, by this world's standards, the richest man in the world. Not even considered rich, but man, by my God's standards, I am saved by His grace. And buddy, that's a blessing right there. I am a blessed man, and we're called to share the blessing. And I hope that if you are my brother and sister in Christ, you are sharing that blessing. You're trying to share your knowledge with folks. And hey, if they don't listen, well, they didn't listen to Jesus Christ when He was here on earth and raising people from the dead. So it happens, but just keep planting that seed and keep watering it. Keep watering it. Keep working for the kingdom. Now, again, I love you. I do. And I want the very best for you. And until I see you again, I pray God may richly bless you and that you'll continue to stand in that gap. This is the Prepping Preacher, guys. I'm out of here.